And how can you find out if your battery is charged or already dead? For that, just drop your battery on the desk with a minus sign from the inch height. A discharged battery will loudly bounce off the desk and most likely fall, while a charged one will land with a clunk without any bouncing. Just in the same way, you can drop your battery flatwise. Compare the sounds when they fall. The secret is that it's a dead battery. The battery as it dances. Exactly this process gives such a bounce. You can surprise the girl you love with a spinning heart made of thick copper wire. Take a wire and make a frame that would look like a heart. Pull a few media magnets with the battery's minus side. Put a heart on the battery's plus side and you'll get a tiny electric motor. It can be different in shape and configuration. For example, we've made such a helix. It's a very cool scene. It's important when the wire touches the magnets, but can be spinning at the same time. If the wire is varnished, then remove the varnish with a small piece of sandpaper in places where it touches the contacts and magnets. If you've dropped a tiny screw on the carpet and have bad eyesight, let's find it with an electromagnet. For this life hack, besides a battery, we are gonna need an iron bolt with a screw nut and a bundle of copper wire. Tightly wind the wire around the bolt along its entire length. All the windings must be done in one direction. It's important. And don't forget to clear up the wire's ends with sandpaper. If the bolt is quite big and you didn't spare the wire for winding, then you'll have a pretty powerful electromagnet. We decided to try and leave the largest wrench we got with this magnet. Our magnet not only lifted the wrench with ease, but it was even hard to detach it. One moment, its weight is almost 1.5 pounds. So you won't have a problem finding a tiny screw on your carpet. With the help of a battery and foil, you could ignite a fire. You have probably already seen this life hack. Take the foil with the paper bases from a Bubble Jeans package and cut a stripe of 6-7 mm width from it. From its center to its edge with scissors. The width in the middle must be around 2 mm. Apply the foil to the battery's contacts and bring it to the paper. And if you use usual foil, then place a piece of cotton wool in the stripe's center. It's important that less the battery is charged, the thinner must be a stripe of foil in the middle. If you are going on a trip or anywhere else when you won't be able to charge your phone, then you should take a 9-volt battery and a car charger with you. Also, you are gonna need a key, but most certainly you'll find it in your pocket. Look, when we apply the car charger to the battery's plus side and the key to the minus side and close them, the indicator lights up. We've attached the key to the car charger with a sticky tape and closed the contacts on the 9-volt battery. Our phone with a 2600 mAh in our accumulator have been charged up to the whole 25%. A battery has helped us again. Don't try to connect a USB cable to a 9-volt battery directly. It could damage your phone because it uses 5 volts while a 9-volt battery gives the whole 9 volts. An AA battery has died in your device and you find only an AAA battery, then just put a piece of foil under the battery's contact and then you won't have to go to a shop for a new battery. And now one interesting trick with an alkaline 9-volt battery. If you open it, you'll find 6 batteries inside. They're a little bit smaller than AAA batteries. The voltage of each one is the same as that of an AAA battery, which is 1.5 volt. Our pocket flashlight has a usual AAA battery. Let's use a improvised life hack and wrap the plug contact of your element from the 9-volt battery with foil and wrap the plus contact of our element from the 9-volt battery with foil. Thus, we can equalize the size. Then put our substitution into the flashlight and now we can use it. You'll get 5 more elements of the 9-volt battery for a spare use. By the way, with 3 such elements connected together, you can charge your phone directly with a cable without a special charging device. You can connect 9-volt batteries with each other. Let's use this to construct an improvised flashlight. For this, we've dismantled a 9-volt cell battery, from which we need a platform with contacts. We've also taken a 9-12-volt LED bulb. We connect the long end of the LED bulb to the hexagonal contact of the platform and fixate it with hot glue. Then we took the long sideways metal strip, cut the excess and fixate it with pliers. In the end, we have got a pretty good flashlight with a simple switch, which obviously will serve much longer than an AA or an AAA battery. And here is one more life hack with a 9-volt battery and 3-volt LEDs. You can construct a unique handle from these. Connect and twist 4 or 5 LEDs by the principle a short end to a long end. We'll get such an interesting construction. The main thing, don't mix up the poles. And now let's place our installation on the 9-volt battery's contact. You can use such a candle in an utilitarian way and as an original addition to a romantic dinner. The main thing is that the voltage of LEDs in total was not less than 5, otherwise they'll quickly overheat and burn out. A 9-volt battery is right.